Good morning. And thanks to organizers for accepting our contribution and in general for organizing this conference, because I think it's very timely and very, very nice and interesting meeting. So as you see, in the Institute of Plant Genetics, there's a group of mathematicians and informaticians, and it is called the group of biometry and bioinformatics, and we work on all data-related problems in the field of genetics and genomics. And today I want to speak about our work towards standardization of phenotypic data. And down in the middle you see the project, which is transplant. And this, what I will describe, is all related to our participation in this project. So I will start by describing this project. So actually this is a collaboration between 11 partners within a consortium which is financed by EU FP7 project, infrastructure initiative. And the aim of the project is to design, implement, deploy and operate an infrastructure which is critically needed for the future needs of plant scientists. So as you saw, the project is finishing this year. And this is the website of the project, so there are several interesting deliverables and actions which were taken during this project. In particular, I want to turn your attention to the resource of genomic data repositories, in the sense that there is a registry of sequence genomes which is updated, and most of the sequence genomes have a record in this repository. There is also a search engine which is running across a number of main databases which contain genomic and biological information. This is a structured semantic search, so this is not just a text search which you can do by general search engines. And there is also variation archive, which is very important initiative, because nowadays it's not a problem of storing and publishing information about single genomes, but the problem is to store and share and make operable information about variation in the genomes, because more and more accessions, plant and forms are being sequenced, so we have to be able to analyze the variation in the genomes. And also, there is a part of the project is devoted to standardization of phenotypic data, and this is where we are in this whole consortium mainly. So what are phenotypic data? So we talk about experiments on plants. And phenotypic data are observations of morphological, resistance, physiological, ERT-related, biochemical, and so on traits. So basically, a phenotype is something which depends on genotype, of course, because this is a manifestation of the genome and gene expression. But the thing is that it also depends on environment. So without description of the environment, phenotypic data are useless. And the characteristic thing is that we talk about a huge spectrum of different characteristics with different sampling protocols, measurement procedures, systems of units, and so on and so on. So really, because of this dependence on environment and this problem of multitude of protocols, it is very difficult to standardize the data. They are kept in many different structures, many different localizations, and that's what we want to improve. So the main deliverables of the work package we work on is a recommended set of ontologies for a description of those data, especially to give some recommendations on the content and format specifications. And this is, in fact, the topic of my talk today. So all these data are obtained in many different experiments in the field, in the greenhouses, in the labs, in some growth chambers. But especially nowadays, the big challenges are the automatic phenotyping platforms, which work mostly by imaging the plants, and then from the images, by image analysis, some useful traits of the plants are derived, and this is done in an automatic way for the whole life cycle of plants, let's say for several weeks, day by day. So this provides a large amount of data, and the problem is if these data are not standardized, we are going to have a huge problem of interoperability in this area. So why to standardize the data? Of course, normally when I talk to biologists, I spend about 10 minutes to convince them that this is important. I think that in this conference, this is not the case. But of course, we want to be able to make the data open, but preserving their structure, which is very important, which means several consequences. But there are also some specific reasons why in this area standardization is important. This should allow for searching for experiments, both in the metadata and data, for comparison of experiments, data integration, and also for statistical analysis, which is hopefully still just by metadata. So how do we approach the problem? So we are trying to give to recommend a minimum information about the plant phenotypic experiment. And we follow the approach which was successful in several areas. There is a biosharing website in which several initiatives of standardization are registered, which means policies, standards, databases. And in fact, in our case, making it really very simple, we talk about results of a phenotypic experiments, which means we have a rectangular table or a matrix. The rows correspond to samples, the columns correspond to the attributes, and now the problem is what sort of attributes we should input here to make to provide all information or data which were collected on for those samples, and to describe, of course, all this information so that it can be shared and understood by other people. So, in fact, what we are going to provide, what we want to provide, is a checklist, which is the list of attributes which should be put here, and this is a list which should be consulted by anyone who is going to publish the data or to share or to store the data in some public repository. So fortunately, we don't have to start from scratch. There were successful initiatives also in the area of plant biology, so there are some standards which are quite well recognized in the area of microarray data, metabolomics and proteomics, and also about how to represent the sequence, the genomic sequence. So we try to follow most of those standards. But actually our checklist consists of the description of study, assay. So we understand that a study is a collection of assays. We have to describe the biosource, so the actual plant form or the genotype which is providing the samples. As I said, we have to describe the environment in which the experiment was done, or maybe the environment was changing during the experiments. We should describe the treatments. Of course, in most of the experiments, we use some treatments to disturb the biological system. There must be the description of the experimental design, and then sample collection and so on. And we think that the main challenge here is the description of the traits, actually the traits, because there is a multitude of them. And also we are trying to give some recommendations about the environmental variables which should describe the environment. Information about the checklist and what we are actually doing has been registered at biosharing website as a record, so you can see the current state of our recommendations at this platform. And then if we go to the data format for data exchange, of course we have a number of requirements from the format that would be suitable for keeping the phenotypic data, and they are usual requirements. It is quite important for us that it should be sort of human readable, compatible with all operating systems, easily made with some simple tools, there was a possibility of using templates, possibly accepted already in some applications, so this is not completely new for biologists. And of course we need to appropriately annotate metadata data and so on. So the obvious candidates are formats like RDF or XML. However, we know from some attempts of using XML for such applications biology that maybe it was the format which was not completely accepted by biologists as not completely human readable. So we turned our attention to ISATA format, which is currently gaining attention in biology and not just. So this is a product of a group which is now currently working at Oxford University. So this is a hierarchical method of describing investigation, which is a collection of studies, and each study is a collection of assays, and each assay can have data files. So we are using this approach to suggest some sort of format for phenotypic data. It has several nice features, and it has been accepted by a new journal, Scientific Data, as a recommended format. It is also accepted the genome space, metabolized database as the form of submission, and it has recently also been recommended by one of the RDA working groups, which is with interoperability data group. So it looks like this. What we have to do, we have to keep phenotypic data, we have to define a isotope configuration, which means we have to define a set of files and the content of those files, and in fact we have to define the form of the assay, and then the types of data, raw data, derived data that we want to have, and some additional data which are files which are necessary to understand all of this. And again, you can find all those information, descriptions and examples on our webpage, which was created specially to share this information. And finally, I just want to show very briefly some applications or implementations of what we are doing within the project. So there is an implementation at INRA, which consists of export of phenotypic data from their database. There is an implementation at IBK in Germany, which again is export from the local information management system. There is an implementation at Gregor Mendel Institute, which concerns the genome-wide association studies and the portal, which is able to import and export the data in this format. And finally, what we are doing is a public database, which is fully compliant with this format and with those requirements. It is based on publicly available BII data manager. It accepts submissions in ISATA format. Now we are running it on our small server, but now we are migrating it to Poznań Supercomputing Center. And we are also building some data analysis tools over around this database. So this is what it looks like. It provides parsing of metadata and classification according to metadata and search. And of course you can download the data in ISATA form. And I also want to show the current publication, which is just now in press, so this is a proof of the paper. You can find all information about what we are doing in this paper, which I think will be published maybe next week. And finally, I want to show the whole group, because there is quite a lot of people involved in this. Our partners in the project, and not just, because we also have a group which is representing some other project, which is European Plant Phenotyping Network. So we are very, very happy to have collaboration with them. And I want to stress that through our partners we have, we know that what we are doing is compatible with, for example, ensemble databases. And we have contacts with Elixir project, which is now very important infrastructure project in Europe concerning data and in the area of biology. And through our French partners, we have also contact with RDA with interoperability groups. So this is important that we hope that what we will finally provide as a recommendation will not be just for us, but this will be a community accepted standard, which is of course critically important for it to be a standard. Thank you very much.